Hello, everyone. My name is Vikas Singhvi. I'm from Electric Power Research Institute based in Tennessee, USA. Those who are not aware of EPRI, EPRI is a nonprofit research organization which conducts research, development, demonstration projects for benefit of public, not just in North America but globally as well. So, with that being said, slightly different topic. So, you know, with rapid growth of both distributed and transmission connected renewable generation, there is definitely a very very big need of tools which can basically provide you a good understanding of how these high penetration of renewable generation can impact the bulk system. So on that note, we actually started developing this tool, which we call Renewable Generation Hosting Capacity Tool for a Transmission Network. The goal was to develop an automated engine for a transmission system which can provide you maximum renewable generation, a transmission region. Region could be a small zone or a bigger area or a whole system or a whole balancing authority area, so which it can host without any network upgrades. Again, the main purpose of this tool is to provide planners to understand or basically do screen through multiple interconnection requests, allowing them for a better understanding of where and how much these renewable generation can impact the system. And it can also help you identify where detailed studies are required to investigate further. Also, it can identify what are the optimal and non-optimal locations of the future renewable generation deployments, such that the grid upgrades can be minimized. So again, one disclaimer I want to put it in front is that this tool does not intend to replace any detailed system impact studies which you guys do on a daily basis, which are very important to make any investment decisions. But it gives you a high level screening on how these increased penetration of renewable can impact your system, which are the regions which are more optimal, which are the regions which are less optimal for these future PV deployments, or sorry, in fact, renewable generation deployments, or in fact, DER as well. So this slide shows the framework. I'm sorry, I'm not sure if you guys can see it, but this slide shows the framework of the tool which we developed. Basically, it's divided into two phases. First phase was just dealing in the steady state space, and then phase two was moving towards a stability side as well, or dynamic performance. So idea was that tool should be able to iterate in a very automated way across multiple combination of generation redispatch, different load levels, different network conditions, different injection nodes where your renewable generation can come online, and then develop this a huge amount of case repository, and then go through the process of you know. For example, in this case, we are using PSSC as a background engine to do all this analysis. So it will do power flow and short circuit analysis and look at, based on the thermal limits, voltage limits, or any short circuit limits which user can provide as a criteria, it basically comes up with what is the maximum renewable generation a particular region can host for a given network condition, for a given load level, or for a given redispatch scenario. So the phase one, which is already there, we are actually in process of validating and across multiple utility systems in US. Phase two, which we'll basically start working on next year, where we'll be trying to add how can the temporal variation of renewable generation can impact the hosting capacity. And also try to add small signal and stability, transient voltage stability as a criteria to evaluate the hosting capacity in addition to steady state limits. So just to give you a quick 10,000 feet overview of the tool design. The first, so it's basically divided into three layers. First layer is the layer where we develop all these cases. The tool can take multiple inputs, as I mentioned before, different redispatch scenarios, load levels, for your winter peak case, summer peak case, off peak case, shoulder levels, things like that. It basically can also take your planned and unplanned outages as well, and develop this case repository. Once you have case repository, the PSSC engine goes through the through each and every case, and based on the provided criteria for voltage, thermal, and short circuit, comes up with the hosting capacity for each case. It also we have also developed a preliminary graphical user interface. So basically, it will show you some stochastic kind of results as well. It also saves all these cases, reports, and logs for each and every case. So if you want to, in future, if you want to pick one case and investigate in more detail, you, the user can do that as well. So with that, the first, just give me a how the process work in terms of developing those cases. So you can, user can provide, as I said, multiple power flow cases representing different load levels. Once you have that, the tool, based on whatever contingency definitions you have provided for the tool, it will model all those contingencies and create this multiple cases. And then based on the locations or potential locations of this future renewable generation or DR deployment, it will start adding those in the cases as well. And then, so then basically it creates all this wide gamut of cases representing all these different conditions. So just to give you, or just to put things in perspective, so for example, if you have two load levels, 10 contingencies, two location sets of renewables, like for example, zone A or zone B, the total number of generated cases will be almost, will be equal to 40. In addition to, there will be four more cases, basically where in which no contingency is modeled, and basically those base cases which represent two load levels and two location sets. So in total you have 44 cases. So just give you an example, this can explode pretty quickly. Like if you have a wide range of contingencies and use different redispatch scenarios, or you want to see sensitivity of different redispatch scenarios, so you can model those as well. So this tool allows you to develop all this base cases, or I should say steady cases, which you can further analyze using the PSSC Python wrapper, which we have developed for this tool. Again, as I mentioned, in terms of analysis layer, so once you have this case repository developed, it's basically iterates through each and every case. It will pick one case, will start increasing the penetration level. Again, that's based on a user input. You can say that I want to keep increasing 10 megawatt of renewable generation in this 10 different injection nodes. So it will keep increasing it to a point where it starts seeing any violation. So as soon as it's seen its first violation, it will flag that case and it will stop, and it will say that is the maximum hosting capacity for that particular case, location set, redispatch scenario, or a network condition. So, and similarly, it will iterate through each and every case like that. Just to give you a very quick a process of how the short circuit limit is enforced. So at every step, it basically makes sure that a short circuit level at that particular injection bus does not exceed beyond a certain user-defined value. Again, it basically ensures that the injection is not being done into a weak bus. So it every step it ensures that limit is not violated and make sure there is no more injection in at any step at a weak bus. So Again, so as I mentioned, we have a graphical user interface with this. So you can see, basically, you can, I'm not sure if you can see that from here, because I'm not able to. You can actually provide how many power flow cases you want. You can provide how many contingency you want this tool to model. You can actually also provide input in CSV files, how many redispatch schemes you have, not just or based on a merit order. You can decommit a unit completely, or you can also say that I don't want, or you can also provide a percentage or amount of megawatt you can reduce that particular generator. So all you can provide through this CSV files. Again, you can also provide different locations where you want to connect renewable generation. You can provide through CSV files, or you can also select right here at the GUI your potential injection nodes. Again, once all the input files have been used and all the cases are being developed, the tool can do steady state analysis. You can provide different checks. You can provide different criteria. You can provide different voltage and branch limits, and you can basically analyze this whole wide spectrum of cases using different criteria and limits, but mainly related to steady state so far. Also, you can So basically, what I want to show here is some of the sample results which this tool can show you. So on the top curve, you can see on the x-axis, which represents each and every case which you have analyzed, basically, which includes the contingency you have modeled, the location set, the redispatch scenario, the load level which you have specified. So it basically analyzes all those cases. It will come up with how much renewable generation each case can have, and just to give you an example, you can see the green bars, which is around 80 megawatt. This is basically the maximum hosting capacity you can have for your current system for a given condition. In fact, you can also zoom in, and you can, for each case, you can zoom and you can see how much of that is my transmission connected PV, how much is a distributed connected resource, or how much is a transmission connected wind. It can show you that as well for each and every case. In addition to that, it also provides you basically a quick understanding of how much violation I'm getting. For example, if you see the left curve, it shows you I'm limited because of a 2.5 MVA overload, and that's why my hosting capacity is 80 megawatt. So if somehow you can operate your system and you can redispatch some conventional generation, or you can operate that particular line for a given amount of time at that much megawatt level, so you can say that my next hosting capacity will be at 400 megawatt. So that's something basically you can look through the combination of thermal violation, voltage violation, and obviously the transformer violations as well, and decide which is the maximum or the minimum of all the three. So that's how you can come up with the hosting capacity number for your system. So again, So we are still, as I mentioned, we are validating this tool across multiple utility systems. Again, this tool, since it's based on megawatt injection, you can use this to see what is the impact of my generation retirement or impact of new injection, different fuel type like gas and other other than renewable generation. You can also use this tool to see what is the impact of increase in load withdrawal. So we are moving in towards that direction. So this is all I have for today. Thank you very much.